It's November 2014 and we are in the Bulgarian capital of Sofia. And we're in basically for the Champions League game between Hooligans and Liverpool. Hooligans is a small provincial team in a city that's about 4 or 5 hour drive from here. And it's the 31st most populous city in the country. So it's got a population of 33,000, and we've heard that tonight there'll be 40,000 in attendance at this pivotal Champions League match against Liverpool. We think most of the fans will be fans of Levski and CSKA Sofia, which are the two dominant sides of Bulgarian football. And I'm here today to make a film which showcases football and life in the city of Sofia in November 2014. Are at CSKA's ground, they call it CSKA, football club in Sofia. This is the most successful club in the history of Bulgarian football.
Екипа с който играе ЦСКА, не за official.
The coach of the national team in 1994 World Cup. We finished fourth.
Yeah.
Той беше треньор.
Former player of CSKA, former coach of CSKA.
Треньор на
honorable coach now of CSKA.
Това е медал от световното първенство.
Yes, this is from the medal for the fourth place in USA in the World Cup.
Това е най-големият български орден, стара планина първа степен.
He's
just parked up in a Kia, and he's about to have a ciggy, but I thought he'd try and have a quick word.
He's the coach of the national team 1994, huge CSKA legend.
Legend.
Living legend.
Living legend. We are the soldiers, we are the soldiers, go ahead Reds. I'm forever faithful. Since I was a child, CSKA lighted the fire in my heart. Win and get win, this is the army. This is the army, guys.
So this is one of the animals.
This is the holy ground.
From CSKA, leading us out onto the pitch.
This is where our dreams come true and where we lose it forever. The happiest and most saddest times in my life.
In recent days, most saddest. Yeah. Not much joy.
Never felt as much love as I've ever felt here. Happiness.
And where is Sector G?
This is Sector G. This is what you call the cop.
So this is Saturday's game against Ludogorets here.
Yeah. Of 200 players and 50 smoke bombs.
And the police say nothing about this, there's no problem.
It's problem, it's not a war.
It's not allowed.
We just smoke them.
But they're not gonna stop 200, are they?
They might
stop one, but not 200.
Yeah, they can't do anything. Once we lit them, the game won for us.
And they don't search you when you come into the ground?
They search, but there's a different ways to get them in.
Yeah.
We always find
it's
a way.
It's like mouse and cat game.
So I'm here with Maro at the away end in CSKA Stadium. So tell me, how many fans would typically come here?
Not many.
No.
Usually, last week we played with Ludogorets, they've got about 50. So that's the normal. There's maybe one or two teams who can bring a few hundred.
The others are just afraid to come.
Many have not enough fans. So
what about Levski? How many would Levski have?
It's usually the game.
Never come.
The game is usually Vitlevski played on the national stadium.
They don't let us play on our club stadiums because huge trouble erupts.
The last derby game played at club ground was in 2011 or 2011 at their ground.
Yeah.
We smashed the whole place. Yeah. The police kicked us at halftime. They just thousands of police was fighting
war on the streets.
Kicked us out of the ground.
Yeah.
And it was war on the street, and they said no more games on the club grounds, only on the national stadium.
Every team in
during
Bulgaria.
During the communist
every
time,
team in Bulgaria
was communist.
What was a communist team? Every team in Bulgaria was
every
a communist team,
was
before the 1989.
Right. Yeah.
When the communists fell, there's no team is now communist, except Levski.
Do you see yourself as a fan or a hooligan or an ultra or all three?
There's a different groups,
different factions, different
mostly
groups.
For the hooliganism. Hooligans.
It's separated. But we have the singers, the one who support, cheering, singing, blah blah blah, and the fighters, the hooligans.
Ultras and the fighters separate.
Right. Okay.
But all behind the team.
Yeah.
So when we stick together,
we are at the same place supporting the team.
There's people who are most interested about hooliganism, the other most interested about supporting, singing, making this
stuff.
Yes, but we are all together on the.
So you know, we see signs around the ground for you know swastikas and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I mean, politically,
this
where
one ACAB, 1-2-1-2.
So politically, where does the club stand then?
Most
of the supporters are far away. Far right.
We
were living in fucking communist country.
Yeah,
if you grow up in the country, in the regime with the communism, there's no way to like this. So many people are with the far right, and some are
many racists and stuff.
Not political active many, but this one who are interested in politics are right.
Because you know people from England who see something like this, because it's obviously a very small minority there.
Yeah.
So this is, you know, the reason I ask these questions is because it's
so different for us.
Yes,
you know.
Yes.
So
yes, but you know, today the word racism is very strange.
I am a vegetarian,
if you
though.
Offend someone from the minority, they call you racist. If someone from the minority abuse me, he's all right, no racist. It's working only the one way.
Yeah.
That's what many people hate, and especially
hear,
in Bulgaria. There's problems with the gypsies, everyone hates them because they don't work, just living on the back of the normal people, taking the benefits. Also there's problems with the Muslims,
It's
we are only 2,000 kilometers from this Islamic state.
Yeah.
So, not Turkey, Syria and this IDL.
ISIS.
Yeah, so it's... on our back door. And
yeah.
Muslim minority in Bulgaria and they're starting to be more active and the fans are the people who are stand against this. Last February there was a march in Plovdiv with us and the other football firms
supporters.
Involved.
Yeah.
So there were
so you come together when
outside. Yeah.
Not
yeah.
This was probably
this
the first
was
time
the
we
first
get
time
together.
We stick together, but it was good.
So if there's a common enemy, you'll be together.
Yeah, of course.
And if there isn't, you'll fight each
yes.
other.
Yes, we don't want someone like I know now in England. This is one of the problems. These Muslim areas, you can't walk your dog. The people can't drink outside of the street. On the street because there's a Muslim patrol telling you it's not right, blah blah blah. If they want to live, if they want to live their lives with the Sharia laws, they can go to fucking Middle East
shit country.
Or whatever. Not coming here to change our country.
Okay.
This is our country. They want to live here. They must live by
they
our rules.
Accept our rules.
Yeah. No, I appreciate what you're saying. So, how many Muslims or Gypsies or you know the others? Are they still tiny minorities? Because when we were
Gypsies
on the way in...
Gypsies and Muslims are not tiny minorities anymore.
Okay, well, when we were on the way in, we were told there's only one mosque in Sofia.
Yeah.
So I'm assuming the Muslim population is quite small. And we were also told to watch out for the gypsies.
Yes.
So were they like the lowest of the low? Is there a ranking order of how you see people?
You know what? What was the plan? Think about the only mosque in Sofia. All the Levski, all Levski Sofia clubs are based around the mosque.
No, it's okay, but it's a big problem with the gypsies because there's a small villages in the countryside.
Yeah.
And they're completely terrorized by the gypsies, stealing from the old people. It was even a few weeks ago, they go and steal from the old couple, something like 100 level, 50, less than 50 quid, broken their arms,
with chainsaws
legs,
and stuff.
They've terrorized them, and it's crazy.
So what do you think of English football fans? Because we've you know built up a reputation of being
reputation. Yeah.
But I still think maybe the English football fans are kind of maybe living off that reputation, or some would like to think you know that the football factory happens every week, those kind of
the system in the UK does not.
In England
allow
now
you to
it's
do it.
No. I have many friends with Liverpool, the other English fans from the old generation.
Yeah.
Pure class. But today it's changed the game in England. It's the new kind of fans, the corporate, the Sky Sports generation, and it's more commercial now. The atmosphere is not good. It's not
they
like
take
here
huge sentences for minor things.
Yeah. So we have lots of laws to prevent hooliganism, right?
Yes.
Introduced after disasters and problems.
Yes.
Do you have laws
yes,
here
we
for
have
that?
Laws.
We have laws, but we don't.
They can come to your house and take you 6 o'clock in the morning. We have 5 guys in the jail at the moment
for nothing.
For
six months now.
6 months. No evidence against
them. No convictions, no nothing. Just stay
in
the jail.
They're in the jail and waiting for a trial. And
they don't even know why they are in the jail. They just stay there.
Yes. Okay. It's hard, yes.
Do you think it's going to get worse, the law? Because when we see
obviously it
footage
get
of flares and stuff like that, and you get one England fan, you know, a fan in England who's getting arrested for flares, and as European football becomes bigger and everyone looks at each other on YouTube, do you think in 10 years you'll be able to come here with the flares and fight against other
because
fans?
Of the
I hope so.
Yeah,
I hope
stuff.
So.
They
try to change it, but as long as we
even
are here,
now,
it,
even
it
now when we
possible.
Start the pyro, everyone is masked and covered.
Right.
They
that
can
that
give
be
you
normal.
1 year ban if they catch you with
the police
with the
stands here,
right.
Takes photos
but
of the people who hold the flares.
Yeah.
And after the game, they wait for us at the exits and arrest us.
Right. But so you must always be ready with a mask.
Yeah, I always have a mask with me.
Like
even
now.
Now, just like in my hood, like this. Always and everywhere.
Constantly ready for action, you can always see through that.
It's different on the Balkans, you know, it's different.
Yeah.
Mentality.
Yeah.
Mentality is different
it's
than everywhere else.
So, where else in of the Balkan region is like this?
We are
Serbia.
Serbia is the same.
Are you allied with them politically? Do you think? Are you similar to Serbia?
Not politically. We are
friendly
things,
friendly fractures.
We have a big friendship with Partizan Belgrade.
Okay.
Alcatraz and Shadows.
They're going to some.
So they were the fan groups of.
Yeah, fan groups of
Alcatraz and Partizan. Yeah.
But we are CSKA Sofia Animals, you know.
Yeah.
The strongest group in Bulgaria and probably on the Balkans.
We are the guest.
What makes you the strongest? Numbers or
not numbers?
Quality.
Okay, so it's all about
quality over
quantity.
The quantity.
Yeah,
it's always better.
Okay, so if you side with one fan group like Partizan in Belgrade, does that mean that you won't like Red Star?
We had
huge fight with Red Star 2 years ago.
Yeah.
We
after one of the derbies on the way back in the gas station, 17 of us beat the shit of 60 of them.
And what about other parts of the Balkans? What about other countries? And
we don't. We are friends also with Steaua Bucharest.
That's
right?
Only Partizan Steaua. Everyone else is not welcome here.
Okay.
You know, Sofia is not the place to walk.
And how? What about the Poles? Legia Warsaw and the big
we
teams in Poland.
Never met
no
them.
Never met them. Yeah.
Because when if you walked around a football ground in England and said, "Where's the biggest hooligans? Where's the most trouble?" They would say certain countries, and Poland would probably be top of the list.
Poland and Russia
maybe,
are the top countries, as long as that's
good
the way I see things.
So why do you think you don't quite have the reputation abroad? because lots of fans who may watch this video in England may not know anything about Bulgarian fans, may think they're peaceful.
For many years
the teams here are shit, so we don't play so too much in Europe.
If you're not good on the grass, you can't can't be reputable on the terraces.
Yes, in last two or
somebody
three years,
needs to take us there.
Yeah.
If CSKA is not playing there,
last two or three
do?
Years, we if have only two games abroad in Europe, which was one this summer in Moldova, and 2 years ago
in Moldova in the summer, huge fight before the game, which beat the shit out of it.
So the sheets are red, and the bins are blue. So they put the trash in the blue of Levski, and sit on the red of CSKA. What's that, Mano?
This is smoke bomb.
This is Spanish smoke bomb.
Spanish smoke bombs.
Spanish?
Italian?
Yeah.
2 minutes.
2 minutes solid smoke.
It's good.
Доста силни са. И са добрите.
So that one's not being used, yeah?
Трябва да се дръп. Не, чак сключва.
Не мога ли нещо?
Това ли се дърп?
Еми май да. Ето ножка. Не знам дали ще става за това.
Just happens to have a knife on him, like.
Military smoke bomb.
It's from the army.
From the army.
So some of the soldiers.
It's covered the tanks.
For the animals.
Yeah.
No. Because when we were army team back in the days, they call us soldiers, you know, it's like army guys.
Who's this for, sorry?
For these five friends of us who are in jail now. No sentence, no nothing, they just stay in jail. This is like we made it in their support. We have also t-shirts the same way. See, 1312, all cops are bastards. 1948, the year of CSKA. It's a smoke bomb left from the last game. We're going to try to light it up for you.
Yeah.
Ima nešto. Knife. That's it.
Та че изгори обаче кости.
Да, това черен дим ще даде.
Не, ще преба, защото...
Защото дупката е много голяма.
Дупката е голяма.
Мари, ей. Толкова. Here it is.
Бре,
готово, пес. Утре ще изгасне огъня.
2 minutes smoke bomb,
It goes like this.
You throw it,
Yeah, throw it on the ground. No problem.
It's quite different, as we said earlier. It's quite different here with the supporters and the fan club and the football club. We have huge influence on the club.
How do you have influence on the club then?
Because it depends on us. The club is for the fans, no? For the directors or the players. Without us, there
football
nothing.
Is for us, you know.
Yeah.
Football is for people.
If we are not happy with how the club is run, they will have problems.
I saw recently there was a game where you lost to a lower league team.
Yeah.
And you made all the players.
Yes.
Come and sit there and you sung at them.
To tell the truth, a few years ago, it was some people were not happy with how the players perform, so
they teach them the lesson that the players have a
dinner in a restaurant, so the boys just go there and smash them.
Sometimes they don't pay every month, you know, and the players are like striking on that they don't get their money on time, but then they had their money, they had everything they needed, but they were still playing shit game, you know,
Yes, not put enough effort.
Yeah.
They
call us, tell us, go teach
them
a lesson.
So they had a lesson, let's say.
Yeah. We went to the restaurant and...
Yeah. And there's no problem for this? Like, the club, they don't tell the club and the club tell the police and the police
come
and get you?
They can tell
everyone. There's no power for the police here.
They can tell whatever they want. That's what we think is right to do, so we just do it.
Yeah.
We don't care.
That's the way we see things.
Yeah.
Might may get arrested, may stay in jail for a few months or year, whatever. But this is the way things should be.
Right.
And the way they want it.
The club.
Well, so the way things are with CSKA at the moment, are you apart from maybe being better on the pitch, is this how you like it?
Yes.
Yeah. It's
depends.
This is your culture and you don't want to change, yeah?
No. Of course.
For many years now, all the fans are together. Everyone is like,
yes, it's a,
like a fist, you know.
The people you can rely on are the ones from the stands.
Yeah.
The rest are...
And what if any immigrants came here? So
where?
Like say, do you have any black fans or anything like that?
No way.
No.
No black, no gypsies, no immigrants.
No gays.
No gays.
Yeah.
Zero tolerance.
Yeah. Zero tolerance for gays. No. Levski supporter and gay is the same thing.
Okay.
Yeah,
so. You make that connection in your mind, yeah.
No, it's not the gays.
We are homophobes.
Yeah.
We don't like them.
Yeah, because it's, I mean, the culture in England is changing to make sure we represent all these.
Yeah, maybe he will.
So do you think this is
what's killing England? The multicultural.
One day, maybe it's going to be changed here, but we will be died years after. We passed away. It may change.
And you say you'll be long dead. But what about the next generation? Do you have like young?
Yes.
Yeah, we have them.
Yes.
Yeah, we have them.
And if CSKA plays a league game in another part of Bulgaria, do you travel?
Huge supporters.
Yeah.
It's
huge numbers.
Usually
the best attended games in Bulgaria.
2,000. 2,000 away fans. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
This is common. But no one else comes here, you go there.
Yeah.
We go everywhere.
And we do whatever we want.
Yeah, it seems to be the case. Because it's not normal for me as an outsider to walk into a ground, shown around by the fans, meet the legendary managers, you know, go where you like.
You seem
to have a lot of power in this.
If you want, we can take you out to the director of
You want to meet the boss?
You know, the doors are always open for us because...
We just give a call.
Yes, just
no,
give
we
a call.
Don't even give a call. We go at the door and say, is he upstairs? Yeah, okay, I'm going.
And you go, yes. So you must be quite well known, you two, here.
Yeah.
Your faces, I mean, I know you don't want to say, I'm the number one, but are you leaders of this hooligan group? Some of the top boys, yeah.
There are many.
How many in the group is there?
That's the animals.
Yeah, and the animals.
About 60-70 people.
60-70, so quite a small, not too big. Yeah.
We don't rely on numbers, on quality.
Because you can't trust anyone. Many people want to join the group, but it should be trusted people. Not everyone.
I understand. So, obviously we're here tonight as Liverpool fans because we're playing Ludogorets.
Yeah.
And, you know, we won the first game and then we've lost three games, so it's a big game for us.
Yeah.
Ludogorets is in a small town.
Yeah.
I think it's the
30,000 population.
Peasants, villagers.
Yeah. But if there's only 33,000 in the town and there's going to be 40,000.
You know why they have so many supporters at the games now? Because their boss, he pays the buses to take the people to the ground.
It's
he give them
this,
money.
You know, Bulgaria is a strange country. Tonight, many people who never been to a football game before will go to watch it just because in Champions League. It's like modern days plastic fans or how you call them, glory hunters.
Yeah.
This is what we don't
this
like
is,
football.
Okay. This to just be. Because it's Champions League, there will be people who never been and will never be after this to this football game.
Right.
But just to take the selfie at the ground, post
wankers.
On the Facebook,
wankers.
Idiots.
Yeah.
You see, absolutely no atmosphere.
Their boss, the owner of Ludogorets, he pays for the coaches, for the buses that bring the people from the country.
Listen,
he gives them money for the
week,
day and food for the day.
Last week we played them, it was
40 people. Imagine over there, 40 people.
40 people.
People.
Yeah. This
so
is the true
who came for nothing. Who came for nothing. They didn't pay for their trip. They came.
This is their true supporters.
People.
So
40
if,
people.
If there are 6,000 in this stadium, because that's the capacity of Ludogorets ground,
yeah?
6,000.
Yeah.
And if the entire town of where Ludogorets play is 33,000.
It's not bad.
And yet there's going to be 40,000 there. Are the rest all from Sofia
tonight? Yes, it's
not
million,
only Sofia.
It's 2 million
from the whole country.
From the whole country, yeah.
That's what I'm telling. Their boss, he pays coaches from every town and city from Bulgaria.
And
you know, when
people.
when they play Steaua Bucuresti,
yeah,
because he got some big fabric here.
Pharmacy fabric.
Manufacturers.
Factories. Pharmacy.
People who work. He said everyone who works on the factory should go to the game, organize buses and...
Or don't take salary, for example, something like this. Yeah.
So you don't... Do you respect Levski more than Ludogorets?
We don't respect both teams.
You don't respect them?
No.
No.
We don't respect Wankers.
You don't respect... Do you respect any other club in CSKA? In Bulgaria?
In Bulgaria?
No,
we don't care about them.
There are no any other clubs.
Yeah, just one club in Bulgaria.
Yeah. And his reserves, huh?
Yeah, two teams. The main team and the reserves.
Yeah. And do you follow the national team, Bulgaria?
No, shite football.
Okay. Yeah.
Don't care.
Really I've been travel a few times in the past, but we hate the idea of mixing with the
when the game is interesting. When the game is interesting, we go. Because
I've been twice in Croatia.
A month ago, we played against Croatia. We had huge history with Croatian fans.
Yeah.
There, here, so we.
And if you're friends with Partizan. You're not going to be friends with the Croats.
No.
So there's problems there.
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
We had the fight before the night before the game. We had fight with Croatian fans. Some of our fans attacked them, take a huge flag of theirs. Then on the game, on the ground, there was huge trouble. Flares.
I've been twice in each Croatia other. With the national team in the past, and both times was lots of troubles.
Mm. We have history there.
But usually these days. Not it's always for us first the club, then the country.
Yeah.
The football thing.
Yeah. But so, you know, that's unusual because most people from capital cities, it's the country first and then the club second. But what I'm saying is you are the exception, not the rule. You seem to be different in almost every respect.
The thing is that here the club is before, even before the family.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
It's coming first, yeah.
Our wives and girlfriends are sometimes jealous of the team.
So we're still at CSKA's ground, and this is just incredible. You know, we've been given a stadium tour by leading hooligans of the Animals group. You know, we just get to walk on the pitch, go in the stands, throw smoke bombs, talk about violence, talk about culture, talk about some of the problems they have with minority groups, and they're quite open with the politics. And from the perspective of someone who's from the UK, it's totally alien. I think unless you come to a place like this and try and engage with people, you're not going to really understand the culture. And I don't think, I'm not trying to excuse away some of their beliefs because they're dramatically different to my own, but I think as a priority sometimes we need to try and engage with people to understand them first before we just simply dismiss what they think, what they believe, what they love, what they stand for. I think this country has a lot to learn, but I also think that the maintenance of culture is something we could probably learn from.
This is one of the directors of the club.
Ah, thank you, Jimmy. Hello. Hello. Welcome to Bulgaria.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
Liverpool.
Liverpool?
Yeah.
Yeah? Great.
So we're going to win tonight?
Yeah, I'll have my fingers crossed for you.
Yeah, not the only one.
Yeah.
We need all the luck we can get tonight. Not very good at the moment, so.
We have to win, eh?
Yeah, we have to
you
win.
You promise me.
We'll do our best.
Okay, thanks a lot.
This is the owner of CSKA.
The owner of CSKA.
Ah, you're from Liverpool, yeah?
Liverpool, yeah.
Welcome.
Pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
Yesterday I met your bosses
you.
And said that it's really a pleasure to have such friends here.
And, well, it's a pleasure for us to be here.
Everybody from CSKA who attend the match today, everybody will go for Liverpool. I'm in a very bad shape because I have to be in the box.
Yeah.
That I have to cry.
Okay. So how do you think we'll do tonight? Do you think we'll win?
Excuse me?
Do you think Liverpool will beat Ludogorets tonight? Or?
Listen, probably, because you know that you're in a downward cycle.
Yeah.
For the moment, it
happens. Yeah.
But nevertheless, they're stronger. Problem that who's going to play 100%. They'll give everything for themselves.
Yeah.
That's why it depends very much of you,
for
Liverpool guys.
But we're going to have more fans supporting Liverpool.
Yes,
more true fans.
Definitely we have more true fans.
Yeah.
Have you heard about Ludogorets
because between 2,000 and 3,000 you have.
Yeah.
Listen, I want very much to have a permanent contact with our fans.
Yeah.
Because I spoke with your boss yesterday. I'll come in London maybe in January, end of January, beginning of February, to sign some contract. And that's why I want to change not only players, young players, but also coaches for experience, etc. And that's why if you can invite our fans to have a permanent contact, I'll be very happy.
I think we've got already established that. I think different fans in Liverpool.
Listen, it's very brave from their side to have such position, because everybody said Bulgarian, but they said no, they are Reds or immigrants.
Of course.
That's why.
Sorry.
Yeah, that's why. That's the truth.
Yeah.
Okay, thank
you. So, as the owner, you have a good relationship with the fans here?
Absolutely. Yeah. I think these fans are incredible.
Yeah.
This is our club is based on triangle. One of the angles, they are fans. Without them, nothing is happening.
Yeah.
Because last year, some very bad guys tried to put our club to finish it.
Yeah.
Tried to close it.
Right. It was almost finished.
It's finished.
Few hours.
I have two letters. One to that club will be in to finish from professional league, and second they are leaving UEFA. Can you come?
With the big
two official letters, and Bulgarian Football Union sent to UEFA that we are leaving
professional football, and
that's why without them. It's impossible to restore the club.
So without the animals, without the fans of CSKA, there's no club here, is that right?
No. This guy is number one. This guy is number one in the standings now.
Yeah.
And he'll do everything possible to be this time champion.
Yeah.
Last time was only president, 5 years ago, we were champions with 16 points difference. Now we have 5, but we'll go more.
Yeah.
Ahead of
this. Big fight.
Big fight for the league.
Well, it's really a pleasure.
Thank you for your time. Brilliant.
Thank you very much.
Yes, but okay, please keep everything.
We'll
be happy to come together, and I don't know how many of ours will come tonight, but
we appreciate the hospitality of some of your fans here, because it's been brilliant to be able to see the
I
club
said
on
yesterday
the
to its woman, the leader of your foundation, Liverpool Foundation, a lady. Yeah, we also will be happy to pay some money for common initiative, everything. We're happy to do this. And I'll speak with the British ambassador maybe later, next week, to see how to communicate. That's why we do.
Thank you.
Ciao. This is Levski. The green ones are Ludogorets. Whoever we see, whatever we see.
And this is, you call this the Tree of Shame, yeah?
Yeah.
So go on, explain where these have come from.
Every time we meet a rival fan, rival supporter, we have a good fight with them and we take off all their articles, like shirts, sweaters, scarves, whatever we take from them. After we beat them, we put on this tree. Tree of shame. Before every game, we take off the old stuff and put the new.
So this is fresh?
Yeah, this is fresh.
This one is made for our guys who are in jail. All the money from these shirts are going to help them.
All these shirts are for normal supporters. Like that one, you cannot get anywhere.
Yes.
But this is only for the animals and the shirts.
These jackets and the shirts, you can't buy them. Shirt. It's only for
anything with the animals logo on it.
This is the normal shirt.
Thank you.